Okay, now you remember that there's this issue of scandal and everything, right? Julius Malema this, Julius Malema that, Floyd Chivambo. Well, something has come up recently, and that thing, it says that Julius Malema and Floyd Chivambo should be brought before court, should be arrested as of now, so they can be afforded an opportunity to come and explain their side of the story. So that should happen as they are actually getting arrested. So, yeah, so it remains to be seen if Julius Malema Floyd Chivambo, it remains to be seen if indeed they will be arrested or not. But again, what you and I know is the fact that, oh, well, you don't know, probably. Now that I'm about to tell you, you'll definitely know. There was an article that was released by eTimes Life, which says that it was released on the 12th of July. It says it was released on the 12th. I didn't see the article. It says, look, it says that it is not the time the NPA, look, Martin, is it not the time the NPA brought Malema and Chivambo to court to test the VPS corruption? That's the claim. Now, I'm going to have to play you a video, Julius Malema, speaking about that. I'm going to have to play you a video, I'm going to have to give you a video, Dalimpofu, speaking about the fact that EFF did indeed confirming that they received the donations and they've answered that question long time ago. But. There's another thing as well. Okay, the video that I'm talking about, which is the one Dalimpofu. It's not a video that I'm going to give you in this specific video. I'm going to give you that video in a separate video, right? So we'll do a separate video about that. Don't worry. Don't you dare worry. Relax. Well, then, the one of Dalimpofu is going to be on a separate video. The one that you're about to hear right now is the one that Julius Malema speaking about this issue, explicitly saying, listen, I have told you before that I have no case to answer here. You are trying to make me an answerable individual, but the bottom line is that I do not have a case to answer. You guys are just, you know what I'm saying, trying to find something against me. Times Life reported. Now, before we get into Times Life, it has also been reported that the guy who was first arrested for EVPS, look, today was released on parole. So we'll talk about that today in today's video. Just give me a moment on that one. We'll talk about that in today's video. What else do we need to talk about? The guy who sentenced 15 years in this VPS. There's more about VPS. The VPS is not about Julius Malema, and it looks not about Julius Malema, Floyd Chivambo, and EFF. There's more than that, right? But. We need to do one, two, or three things, and those things are this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so the assertion or the proposition, whatever you want to call it, that Julius Malema and Floyd Chivambo, it is the proper time for them to be brought before the court. It came from this. Let me give you the background. Times Life, they say they claim by former VPS mutual chairperson Chifiwa Matodzi that he had initially paid EFF and then made 1 million monthly donation to the EFF to clean up the bank's bad reputation after it gave former President Jacob Zuma a home loan for Nkandla, sparked a debate. In other words, here, basically, they were busy sanitizing the brand. They were busy targeting people that were making noise about it. I get it. Like, honestly, I get it. But at the same time, the manner in which they went about it, it's just questionable, right? It's just questionable. They said the funds were allegedly... okay, it's fine. Let's leave this one. I was just giving you a background on this one. So then, according to these people, they are saying, right, Floyd Shivambo indicated they opened an account at VPS, myself, Julius Malema, Floyd Shivambo, understand that the concept of donations to mean gratification. Hence, Floyd Shivambo did not provide the EFF's own banking details. I've already covered this, right? So, Times Life, basically, they are saying, if you read this article further, it says that, look, as you read the concept of this article, it basically, or the not even the concept, man, as you read the content or the essence or the key or the theme, the underlining theme in this article, it says that this political party, EFF, right? EFF, Shivambu, Shivambu EFF as a political party, Shivambu a member of EFF, Julius Malema a member of EFF. They are saying because of their contribution, because of what they have received, the NPA must bring them before court so they can come and tell their side of the story. Now here's the problem. Now, my problem with this is that when you start seeing newspapers starting to push the agenda of an NPA arresting them so they can come and say their side of the story, it's a problem because, number one, the VPS thing is made to be an EFF thing. Whereas it's not, VPS, guys, is not about EFF. And in fact, there are people who benefited more than people who belong to EFF, such as Malema, Floyd Shivambo, or EFF itself. There are people who benefited more than that. The problem I have with this thing of us marrying things, or, you know what I'm saying? There's a problem with how we think concerning this. There's a serious problem in how we think. Why am I saying there's a serious problem in how we think? It's because, do not allow media to fool you. Now that media is pushing the agenda that Floyd Shivambo and they are making this EFF thing dirty, right? The brand, the EFF, yeah, they looted VPS. Okay, we get it. They do acknowledge that they benefited. But here's the thing. The very same media, when they write about Judge John Thorpe, they say they impeached Judge. When they write about Dudumien, you know what they say? They disgraced Chairperson even when she was dead. But listen to this one. You hear how they write about EFF? How they write about Malema, how they write about Floyd Shivambo, how they talk about Zuma, how they talk about Judge Thorpe, how they talk about the late Dudumien. But listen to this one. How do they talk about Palapala? In fact, let's leave the question, how do they even talk about Palapala? Then you want to tell me, they have done investigation. No, there's no investigation. Nonsense. There's nothing here. What you have here is people deliberately choosing to turn a blind eye on anything that has got to do with Palapala, but everything that has got to do with the enemies of Palapala. Technically, the media is on the side of Palapala. Palapala is directly linked to that crime. Whilst the issue of Abo Shivambu and everybody, it's not directly linked, Palapala. He himself, he acknowledges that money was under matras. It's a criminal offense. When he's being called, you know what it does? He calls people that are going to favor him and he says, the processes have made, have sanctified me. Now I'm holy. Hey, Palapala. The media is scared to talk about Palapala. So if they are scared to talk about Palapala, why do you trust them that whatever they are writing to you is the truth? No. They are not telling the truth. They are telling you what they want you to know. But I'm going to ask you this in conclusion. During the election campaign, during everything, tell me, have you ever seen people calling Ramaphosa, telling him that, "Ye baba, we know the money you ate in Gaza. Tell me that. Please tell me if they've done that." I don't remember, Mina. But maybe when you do, Mina, I don't.